Starting the class. This is the very first class of this semester. Management Information System is the subject name. Now this subject, Management Information System. This is a very important subject in today's perspective. As because here we will integrate computer science, information technology with management. Till date, whatever subject you have got, those are more or less based on management and on mathematics and all that. This is the subject where we will see how information systems can be applied on business to enhance the inherent qualities of business. Here we will see that how we can more effectively run different businesses by applying the knowledge of information system. So to understand the overall subject, Management Information System, we have to understand several things. At first, we must have to know what is management. And that part, I think you are expert in that part. As because you people are a management student, so you know what is management. You have got lots of papers on management. You will get more papers in management in future also. So management, what is management? I think that is clear to you, more or less. But here, our job is much more. That is, basically, here we don't have to not only understand only what is management, with that we have to understand what is information system, and how we can apply information systems on the management. Now, as there are different kinds of management, different aspects of businesses, so obviously, there'll be different types of information systems as well, specifically designed for some specific purposes. So I have to know all these things.
Good afternoon, sir.
So we have to know all these things. So, if I say, what is management information system? So, we have to say that a management information system is a computer system consisting of hardware and software that serves as the backbone of an organization's several operations. And not only that, in addition to this, and MIS gathers data from multiple online systems. It analyzes the information and reports data to aid in management decision making. So from the given definition, whatever I told you just now, we can understand one more thing, and that is we are applying information system on management to take better decisions for our organization, for our businesses. So obviously, from here, you can understand that MIS is also the study of how such kind of information systems work. So coming to the first important aspect, and that is improved decision making. That's because we have seen that management information system is helping us to take better decisions for our businesses. So obviously, improved decision making is a vital factor over here. Now, how we can do that? That is the question. How we can do that? How we can improve our decision-making abilities for our organization by applying this kind of systems? Basically, the key factor, the key things over here is that different information systems will provide, or we should say, it should provide up-to-date, accurate, timely data on a variety of organizational assets. Here, when I'm saying assets, I'm not talking about assets in trial balance and all that. I'm not talking about that. Actually, assets here means there could be many things like financial matters, inventory related matters, personnel related matters, project timelines related matters, manufacturing issues. If it is a real estate organization, so real estate issues, marketing issues, raw materials, R&D, that is research and development, all these things. So based from all these aspects, we have to take timely, accurate data, and we have to analyze those data and have to generate several meaningful reports out of it so that these timely, accurate reports can be presented in front of our organizational managers, which will help them to take better decisions for the organization. Suppose comparing sales of the current month to the sales a year ago by looking at staffing level, which may point to ways that how we can boost revenue much more for our organization. So what you are doing here, suppose your boss has told you to find out the different ways how you can boost, how you can increase the revenue. So for that, what you have to analyze? You have to analyze, suppose the sales of this month, current month of this year, and suppose sales of the same month in the previous year. So you can understand that whether you are going down, whether your business is going down, or it is improving. Now that can be an aspect, that can be a way which will help you to find out the ways of boosting revenues for your organization, which will help you as a manager. Or suppose you are comparing marketing expenditures of your organization in different geographic locations. So this data, whatever you have gathered, first of all, you have to gather those data. You have to gather meaningful data, timely data, accurate data. Then you have to analyze those data. And then you have to present those data in a meaningful way, in a meaningful format, which will help your organization to solve some problem in an effective way. So that is the basic aim of MIS. So here, whenever we will going to talk about MIS, few terms will come frequently. Among them, information is one. Now the question is, what is an information, or what is information? Now, in a nutshell, we can say that information is a processed data. Information is a processed data. We are processing data. We are gathering information. We are creating information. So obviously the question is coming that what is the difference between information and data? So information is processed data. That means data, whenever we are calling data, that is the raw things, whatever you are collecting from your environment. Now, in business perspective, that environment, we are talking about business environment. Now, in your business environment, lots of things are coming. Your internal organization's environment and environment of your outside organization, organizations outside things like government, customers, competitors. So you have to collect data from all everywhere, actually. And then you have to process those things to generate some meaningful information, which will ultimately be used as an input to different computer systems. We are calling it information system, which will be used as an input to the different information systems. And those systems, the responsibility of those systems is to analyze those informations further, those data further, to produce meaningful and timely information. So the things are like that. So here, suppose there is an example. Suppose I'm giving you a number. You can see it is on screen. So if I give you just this number, if I am not telling you what is the thing it is, if I just giving you some number, so it will not make any sense to you because you don't know what it is actually. It's just a raw data actually. It is just a raw data in that case. So this is the raw data. Suppose I'm giving you a number, like 50, 60, 70, 80, 20, 25, 35, 45. I'm just giving you some numbers. So that is basically the raw data. Now, if I say that, okay, I'm giving you the marks of the subject MIS, whatever you have scored in the last exam. And then I'm telling you these numbers, 50, 20, 30, 40, according to some roll numbers and all that. So that will make some sense to you. So that will, you can understand that, okay, this is our marks. You have got these marks. So like that, here, some number is given. So it's a raw data. Yeah, Bishwajit. Bishwajit, ball. Ball, Bishwajit, you have to let us. Sound Ashana. Okay. I'm not getting your sound, Bishwajit. If you have any more question, please ask me. So now, if we say that this is a telephone number, then it will start to make some sense. Now, if I give you some more information, like address is such and such, telephone number is such and such, fax number is such and such. So now it will become, it becomes a very useful information that it is a...
Sir, now I'm audible.
Yeah, now you are audible. Tell me.
Sir, as you have said about the information and data, the information is structured data and data is generally unstructured in nature.
We will discuss regarding those things in future. Obviously, there is some structured and unstructured things are there. In general, you can say that information is structured data and data is unstructured. You can say that. That is fine. In general, you can say that. Okay. for your simplicity, I'm accepting right now the concept that information, you can think like that. Information is structured thing and data is unstructured, but it is not true always. It's not true always. We will see actually unstructured information in future as well.
Okay.
So it is not like that. Always information will be structured. But yeah, in general, you can say that right now. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So we have understood that what is the difference between raw data and information. Whenever you are processing information, so it becomes processing data, it becomes information. Now this processing has some steps actually. Question is how this data is processed to information. So that is the question. How this data is processed to information, is getting processed to information. For that, you need some input. You will have a processing element and you will have some output. So what is input? Input is your raw data. What is output? Output is the information, what you are generating. And what is the processing element? The processing element where your data is getting converted to information, that is the processing element is. Now, whenever I'm saying processing element, in computer science term, it's basically we're talking about the processor. Now, suppose, just to give you a very generalized example, suppose you are giving some input to your calculator, some numbers, and with some operation, that is whether you want to plus or minus or whatever it is. So you are giving some numbers to your calculator, that is input. You are instructing your calculator to do some specific task. So your calculator is processing that and displaying you the result. So in the same way, your information system will work, where you will provide some input, which is raw data actually. Then your information will be processed in processor via processor. And from there, it will generate some meaningful output. So, from here, we can say that an information system is a system that gathers data, and disseminates information with the sole purpose of providing those informations to its users. So that is the job of the information system. Information system is doing what? It is gathering data. Now that data can be fed by user manually. That data can come from another system. Maybe it is an automatic system. Your information system is gathering data automatically from some another system. Whatever it may be manual, maybe automatic. That is, I'm not going into that detail. But the thing is, your information system should have some source of input data. Then only it will be possible for your information system to process those data in a desired format and providing the output to the users. Now, these information systems, it can have several types. It can have several forms. Like right now, just I'm giving you an example, like TPS, Transaction Processing System. Now, what is TPS? Full form is Transaction Processing System. What is the purpose of it? The purpose of TPS is to gather information about each and every transaction running in an organization and producing output based on those given input. That is the sole purpose of TPS. Who will be benefited from this TPS, by this TPS? Now, you know that there are different levels of management in an organization. Lower level or operational level, middle level and top level. Generally, TPS will help lower level and middle level managers. So, you can understand from this example, the main objective of an information system is to provide information to its users, desired users. Every information system is designed for some specific purposes, targeting some specific kind of users. That thing you must have to understand first. Not every information system is going to help every users in an organization. Some information system like executive information system. There is an information system. You will see all these things in detail. I'm just giving you names. Executive information systems will help top level executives of an organization to take better decisions. So it is just kind of a helping tool to the managers. Because you know, nowadays our business has been very, very complex. It is a very, very complex environment we are running. I mean, there are lots of competitors, lots of factors. Lots of products are in market. I mean, same kind of product I'm talking about. Suppose a soap, taking a soap. Now, there are lots of soap. There are lots of organizations, lots of companies making soap, toilet soaps. So, competition is huge. Now, to sustain in the market, you have to produce better product. To sustain in the market, you have to reach to the needs of your customer. To sustain in the market, You have to be informative enough to sustain in the market. You have to produce your product and deliver it to your customers in a reasonable price and as quick as possible. So to run your business, keeping all these things in your mind, we need to gather lots of data, analyze those data, produce some meaningful information from it, then only we can sustain in the market, otherwise not. Information system helps in that purposes in your business. Now, nowadays, the form of this management information system, amra ei syllabus e ja ja porbo, nowadays it has become much more complex. Nowadays it has become much more complex than that. Nowadays, what we do? We analyze data. There is a subject actually, data analysis, data science. These are some subjects actually, which have, these subjects has been originated from this MIS and all these things actually, from all these things. So nowadays we have able to reach the heart of our customer individually. You have to reach individually to your customer, specifically to single customer, to sustain in the market. So we can understand how tough it is for an organization. So your information system will help to achieve those things. Otherwise, manually it is not possible for any organization. Because we need some processing capability. We need speed. Je speed e the data, collected data can be processed. So that is the thing. That is the thing about information system. So ami shegulo ekhane bola ache, shegulo I bollam. The management information system is an information system that evaluates, analyzes and processes an organization's data to produce meaningful and useful information based on which the management can take right decisions to ensure future growth of the organization. Obviously, our main aim is to future growth. Main aim is to achieve future growth of our organization. So up to this, I've just given you the concept of what is the information system, what is management information system, what is the need of it, why we need to study this subject as because we can, so that we can apply our information system knowledge on the business, and that is our sole purpose to studying this subject. That is why this subject is in your syllabus in BBA, because this is the blend of this subject, is a mixture of management and information, mixture of management and computer science. Actually, it's a mixture of management and computer science. It will guide us that how we can use information systems in our business. So up to this, if anybody has any question, please tell me.
Sir, hello.
Bolo, Vishwajit, bolo.
Sir, eta ki tahole sir decision making e amaderke help kore, mane amra
obviously. Suppose you are in a situation where you have, as a manager, you have more than one options. Now you are confused that which option you should opt.
Yes,
so some information system, if you are using some information system, it will give you, it will show you some trend that, okay, option one will give you this much profit. Option two will give you this much profit. Option three will give you this much profit. Probable. So obviously, it is, it will be probable. So it will indicate some pattern. It will indicate some tendency. Not exactly, some tendency, some general tendency.
So both in management and the information system, a subject like one strategic planning is only used for a high.
Not only strategic planning.
Competitor, the company has a shaky.
Not only strategic planning, for each and every kind of planning you know for business. Each and every kind of planning. Not only strategic planning. Each and every kind of planning, it will help in each and every kind of planning.
Yes, sir.
It will help you each and every kind of decision. If you can use it properly, it will help you in any situation. But obviously, those situations will be a, it will show, it is a system. You can understand, it's a system. So it will show you some tendency. That may be 95% correct. That may be 90% correct. Maybe sometimes 99% correct. Maybe sometimes 100% correct. But not always. So that's the thing is. I hope you have got my...
হ্যাঁ স্যার বলছি, তার মানে আজকে আমরা অর্গানাইজেশন বা বিজনেসে যতগুলো টেকনোলজি ইউজ করছি সবগুলোই তো ইনফরমেশন টেক ম্যানেজমেন্ট ইনফরমেশন এর মধ্যে চলে আসছে, মানে আমরা বলতে গেলে ঘিরে আছি আর আজকে।